When you're hot, you're hot. And that's the case for Prodrive Racing Australia, which has a total of 9 race wins and 8 pole positions so far in the 2015 V8 Supercars Championship. This weekend, the series stops at Queensland Raceway, the home track for young gun Chaz Mostert, who is aiming to add to his 2 victories and 8 pole awards.
Yeah, the car's been lickety-split this year so far, so it's firing on all cylinders. The Ford Falcon FGX has really come to grips this year, and we've really learned a lot about the car. So each round we've had good results, even rounds we don't think we're that quite strong at, maybe Townsville, and we've been at the pointy end. So to go to some tracks where we've had some recent success in the old FG, and now we've got the upgrade FGX package, it's going to be pretty cool to go see what it can do there.
The performance from the Pepsi Max crew entries of Mostert and championship leader Mark Winterbottom, along with the Bottle-O entry of David Reynolds, has put all the other teams on notice. But the Tim Edwards-led Blue Oval Brigade has no plans in easing back over the second half of the season.
They're coming. There's no doubt about that. You know, they're all coming for us, and we've just got to make sure that we stay one step ahead of them. And we've just got to keep doing what we're doing. But, there's no way we can sort of rest on our laurels. You know, we've absolutely got to keep developing this car, because if we left the car as it is, you know, from now to the end of the year, then we'll be, we won't be in the hunt.
It's not easy. You've got to keep evolving. You've got to keep moving with the times. It's, because we've got a strong package at the moment, doesn't mean we just sit here and not reinvent the wheel. We come up with new ideas every time we go out the track. Last couple of events, we've changed a lot with the car, and it's proved to work. So it's the tunability at the moment with the car is really working really well. And we just got to keep coming up with new ideas and keep trying to stay towards the pointy end.
This weekend's action at Queensland Raceway will include 2 60-kilometre sprints on Saturday and a single 200-kilometre race with pit stops on the Sunday.